Since the inception of the West African Senior Secondary School Certificate Examination, university requirement has largely called for 5 subjects. Mandatory among these are English language and mathematics. Every year, thousands of students run into the course of either having to resit for not getting credits on English and mathematics, or painfully changing career path owing to same. To help modify this narrative, Star Television presents on your screen Learning Garage, a platform that guarantees better performance in English language and mathematics with a team of experienced teachers. To this solution, you all are invited, especially those facing WASC. Learning Garage comes to you on Mondays, Wednesdays and Fridays from 7 p.m. to 8 p.m. Repeat broadcast are screened on Saturdays from 7 a.m. to 8 a.m. and on Sundays from 1 p.m. to 2 p.m. Join host Ali Santa Kamara.
If you mean such element, then of course we say the waters of the world in that regard.
And Babatunde Gaira Lamin on these days to make a world of difference.
Action that has a numerator which is less than the denominator, we term it as a proper fraction.
Hello there. I am Santa and this is Learning Garage. Well, we are going to proceed with verbs. Of course, in our last two editions, we looked at verbs and then we, in fact, saw how significant they are. We encounter its component and then we are proceeding. We have a number of components to look at when it comes to verb. Today, we have 3 or 4 of those kind we look at. The first we'll begin with is what we refer to as those elements that, of course, will attract ing words, meaning words and expressions that attract ing. Meaning words, if we use them, we will be required to use ing elements. That ing element we call gerund. So that will be the first thing to look at in this edition. So we have what like admit, what like adore, you know, avoid, consider. If you use these words, the verb-like elements coming require an ing. That ing is called gerund. So you have to have this in mind. Of course, learn them. We will, of course, look at them. Word like admit, word like adore, these ones, if we use them, we will, of course, require ing. They attract ing. The verb-like word coming supposed to take ing. Word like avoid, word like consider, word like delay, word like deny, you know, word like detest, meaning hate, word like dislike, word like enjoy. If you use these words, you require ing. I enjoyed doing it. You see, after enjoy, you have ing element. She admitted stealing the fish. After admitted, you see ing. So when we use these words, we require an ing element, an ing word. So word like finish, word like imagine, word like involve, word like keep, word like mind, word like miss, okay, word like notice, word like postpone, the T is silent, cannot say postpone, okay, is it postpone, word like practice, you know, word like busy, I am busy doing it, I am busy saying it, meaning after busy, after practice, the word coming require an ing, okay, the word coming requires an ing. We have resent, we have risk, okay, we have can't help, this is an expression. I can't help doing it, I can't help crying, I can't help laughing, for instance. So when you use this expression, you require an ing. I can't help laughing, I can't help dancing. So when you use can't help, when you use resent, you require an ing. Please have them in mind. Can't stand, the same thing, you know, feel like. It's no use, you see, it's no use being here, it's no use going there, it's no use staying here, for instance, you see. So it's worth Is what also mean it is worth. Also, is worthless. I mean, it's worthwhile. One expression, you know, look forward to. For instance, I look forward to seeing you tomorrow, or I look forward to having time with you tomorrow, for instance. So when we use all these words and expressions, we require an ing element. You see again, object to, be accustomed to. When we say be accustomed to, the be actually has to do with the am, the is, the was, the are, the were. So whenever you hear be actually involves is, was, are, am. They are all on the be. Okay, we call them paradigms of be. Okay, so okay, then we have again be committed to. Same thing applies. When we say be committed to, we actually mean I am committed to, he is committed to, for instance. Okay, they are committed to. So be just mean am, is, was, are, in short, just be. So also be accustomed to could mean I'm accustomed to, could mean is accustomed to. So be accustomed to has to do with the am, the is, you call them up. So and a number of other elements. When we use all these words and expressions, we are to use gerund, or we are to use ing element after them. Okay, so the ing element is called gerund. But I'll not go further talking about gerund because this class is not devoted to gerund. Please, we will find time for gerund. But to make it very, easy to see, we'll say, in fact, these words attract ing. Okay, so example, you see, we have Umu admitted telling a false story. You see, we have telling just after the verb admitted, because admitted is one kind of verb that attracts ing. So Umu admitted telling. See, we don't say Umu admitted tell or admitted to tell, for instance. So just after admitted or admit, we require an ing element. And you will see, for instance, in fact, tell carries ing. Umu admitted telling a false story at that. Next, Khadija delays going home. You see, in fact, we have going because we have here delay. And of course, delay is a kind of word that attracts a gerund or that attracts ing element. Another one would be, I enjoy playing football. You see, we have ing element just after the verb enjoy. Okay, to give you the impression that whenever we use enjoy, admit or admitted, delay, you call them up, we require an ing element. That ing element is called gerund. But we will not say anything further about gerund because this class is not about gerund actually. So if that is the case, if you have in fact if you have had a very cool way into these words, if you actually have some idea about them, that in fact if you use them we require ing element, let's look at some past questions with questions regarding these words. And here we have, when we visited the television studio, I was busy - acoustic devices, June 1991. When we visited the television studio, I was busy - acoustic devices. You see, the key thing here is busy. We of course should in fact have it in mind that the word coming after busy should in fact carry an ing element, because busy is a word that attracts ing element, or it's a word that attracts, of course, gerund. So here we have admiring. When we visited the television studio, I was busy admiring acoustic devices. So of course, A is our answer. B, we have to admire, is wrong. Of course, after busy, we require ing element. C, in admiring is wrong. Okay, we cannot have in that sequence. D, to have admired is wrong. So our answer is of course A. We are considering - the meeting to next Friday. You would say meeting if you want to sound American. You would say meeting if you want to maintain the RP version, the RP system of pronouncing words. Okay, so we are considering - the meeting to next Friday, November 1991. Now the key thing has been considering. Okay? Any element occupying this space supposed to be one carrying ing, supposed to be one carrying ing. So here we have here to postpone is wrong because we have two, and of course the verb itself is infinitive. Then B, we have having postponing. We cannot have two ing elements, three ing elements on the chart. We are considering having postponing. Cannot be the case. Then C, we are postponing. We are considering postponing is fine. C is our answer. And of course, D in postponing is wrong. So our answer is what? Is C. So we get down to the other question. Would you mind dash this check for me? Would you mind dash this check for me? June 1999. Remember, the key thing here is mind. The key word is mind. Mind is a kind of word that attracts, that takes jiron, that require a jiron, or that require a word. Okay? A word with ing. Okay, so here we have, would you mind signing this check for me is wrong. B, would you mind signing this check for me is fine. Okay, C, would you mind to sign in? No. D, would you mind to sign? Of course. So our answer is what? Is, of course, option B. Okay, we proceed. I am not accustomed dash on an empty stomach. June 2002. You see, the expression have to do with am and, of course, accustomed. Okay, so the full expression is be accustomed to. Be accustomed to. We have be has to do with the am, the is, the was, the are. They're all there. Okay, be has to do with the am, the is, the was, the are, the were. Very, very essential. So, then a paradigm of be is there, which is am. Okay, and the other component of the expression is committed. We have committed, accustomed is there. And what is left out is to, because we are supposed to have I am committed to. That's the full expression. After am committed, we require to. After to, we require an ing element after to. That's the complete expression. But here we are being tested for two things. We are being tested on which particle should, of course, go along with a custom, and which of course is two, not four, or in fact any other one is two. So after a custom, we require two, and after two, we require an ing element. So we are being tested for two things. First, which kind of what we refer to as particle. I will not call two as preposition or infinitive in this case. Two is a particle. A particle is a word that does not belong to any part of speech. Okay? So two in this context does not belong to any part of speech. So I'm not saying two is a preposition here. Okay? So, but the correct expression is be accustomed to. I told you when you say be, you mean the arm, you mean the east, you mean the words, you mean the are, they're all there. And next is accustomed. And next you require two. And after two, you require an ing element. Together, of course, that would be enough for what we will find for the answer. So now we have here, I am not accustomed dash on an empty stomach. So of course, A, to sleep is wrong. Okay, we have the two here, but of course, we require an ing element after the entire expression. So of course, A is wrong. B, to have slept is wrong, because of course, we of course have the two, but the two elements after two are of course out of the case. C, we have for sleeping. So we have, C is wrong for two reasons. Because four cannot, of course, four is not part of the expression, and sleeping is fine, okay, but we'll of course leave it at that. And D, to sleeping is fine, because of course we have a word that completes the expression, and in fact, the principle that, in fact, after be accustomed to, we require an energy element is being fulfilled there. So of course, D is our answer, okay. The maid denied dash our mistress's money. The maid denied dash our mistress's money. June 2002. Okay, here the contention has been denied. After deny or past tense denied, we require an ing element, or we require a word containing ing. You know, of course. So A, to stealing. No, we are not to use to after deny. So we just require an ing element just after deny. So A is wrong. B, stolen. Of course, we cannot take the past participle form to use next to use after deny. So of course B is wrong. C, to have stolen, is also wrong. And D, stealing, our answer is of course option D. The maid denied stealing her mistress's money. So D is our answer. The group is committed to Daesh for international peace. Okay, so here again, we have the three components making the expression. So we have forms of a paradigm of B, is here. We have committed, we have two, meaning the three components making the expression are all present. So what we now need after the expression, we require an ing element. That's it. So okay, so A, we have work. The group is committed to work is wrong. B, the group is committed to worked. Very wrong at that. C, the group is committed. C, to working is fine. The group is committed to working is fine. And of course, D, the group is committed to be working wrong. Okay, we cannot, of course, use B in this context. So C is our answer. So you see, if you have this one in mind, then you have, in fact, helped yourself. That in fact deny, committed to, can't stand, you know, it is what it's worthwhile, it's what. If you use these expressions and words, you require an ing element after them. If that one is clear, then you see, because we follow principles, you see how we are able to in fact see the answers, how we are able to in fact respond to the questions as in fact grammar requires at that. So we proceed to the next aspect. The next aspect of this class will be using used to, using be used to or get used to. Very, very essential. Used to. Be used to. When I say be used to, you know now, be actually has to do with the am, the is, the was, the are, the were. So when I say be used to, it means I'm used to, is used to, was used to, for instance. That would be, in fact, what I mean here. You know, so then again, we have get used to. So let me explain. Used to, be used to, get used to, and even become used to at that. So we use used to talk about past habitual activity, okay, that has no current relevance. Meaning something we used to do in the past, but in fact we're not doing again. So we'll say used to. I used to, of course, when I was in the village, I used to go swimming, every Sunday, for instance. So meaning that's a past habitual activity, that every Sunday in the past, you know, I would go swimming every Sunday in the past. So it's, we use the expression used to, used, should be in past tense. So why in past tense? To indicate, to give us an expression of, an impression of, in fact, of past thing, you know, past, activity at that. So used to, we use the expression used to talk about past habitual activity, something we are not doing any longer, but we used to do in the past. Now, be used to, when I say be used to, I mean the am used to, is used to, or are used to. Be has to do with am, is, was, are, you call them up. So you see, be used to has to do with am, is, was, are. So be used to, we use be used to talk about, something we are accustomed to, something, you know, we don't find unusual any longer. Something we are accustomed to, we don't find it unusual any longer. See, so I am used to sleeping on an empty stomach. You see, I am used to sleeping on an empty stomach. No problem. I have got used to it. It is part of my habit now. That is the be used to stuff. Then we use get used to or become used to when we are like trying to get accustomed to a practice, to an activity at that. Get used to or become used to. When we are trying, okay, to get accustomed to a practice or to an activity. Let me go over again. Used to actually is about past, habitual activity, something we used to do in the past, but we're not doing again. Be used to, the am used to, or is used to, or are used to. It's about something we are trying to get accustomed to. There are something we are used to, something we are accustomed to. But get used to is about something we are trying to get used to, something we are trying to get accustomed to. Get accustomed to that, the word, or used to the past. Be used to something we are accustomed to, get used to and become used to something we are trying to be accustomed to. I hope that is very clear. Let me go again. Be used to is about something we are accustomed to. We have got accustomed to. Get used to is about something we are trying to get used to. We're trying to be accustomed to. Okay? The be used to, you are accustomed to it. Get used to, trying to get, accustomed to something. But used to is about past, habitual activity. Very, very essential. So if the meanings have sunk down, we'll now, of course, get down to, the principles. So now, let me just finish with used to. There is another word we'll use to talk about, past habitual activity. If you want to use used to, you will use would. Would. See? When I was in the village, I would go swimming every Sunday, meaning past usual activity. So if you don't use used to, you will use would. W-O-U-L-D. Would. Okay? When I was in the village, I would go swimming. I would go swimming every Sunday. Or I used to go swimming every Sunday. So would and used to are in fact the components you would use to talk about, past habitual activity. But of course, be used to and get used to, and in fact even become used to, the be used to is about something you are accustomed to, get used to and become used to, something what you are trying to get, accustomed to. Okay, that's the reality. And here we have a number of things. So we used to talk about past habitual activity that have no current relevance. So example here we have, when Alpha was in primary school, he used to write short stories every day. It's about past habitual activity. Alpha no longer does this. I used to eat meat, but I became a vegetarian 5 years ago. So you see again, the used to is about past habitual activity. Something, you used to do, but now in fact no longer doing. So we proceed. I told you can use would in the place of what? Used to. You want to use used to, you can use would to refer to past habitual activity. Something you are no longer doing again. Don't say we used to do it. If you say we used to do it, that you are talking about the past. But if you mean now, then of course you have run into mistake. Okay? So we proceed. Now I've given you the meaning of these two. What is very essential is that you can use a noun or a pronoun or a verbal element after be used to, get used to, and become used to. Okay? You can use a noun or a pronoun or a verbal element after get used to, after become used to. So if you have a noun after be used to, get used to, become used to, no problem. If you have a pronoun, no problem. Okay? But if you have a verbal element after get used to, after become used to, after, be used to, that verbal element supposed to carry ing. Okay? If you have a verb after be used to, get used to, and become used to, if you have a verb after these expressions, that verb supposed to come in ing. Okay, that's very, very essential at that. If you can have a noun after be used to and get used to and become used to, no problem. You can have a pronoun, no problem. But if you have a verb after them, that verb supposed to in fact carry ing. Very essential. Example here. I am getting used to waking up early. You see? So the element has been getting used to or get used to. So because we have a verb-like element after get used to, what do? We, of course, bring it in what? In ing. So I'm getting used to waking up early. That's it. I find cassava leaf sauce very strange, but I am used to it now. So now we have I'm used to, or be used to in this case, okay? And we have a pronoun after the entire expression. So no problem. If you have, you can have a pronoun, you can have even a noun, you can have, a verb, but if you have a verb after this expression, that verb is supposed to come with ing. Very, very essential to note, okay? So let's have a look at some questions. One or two past questions regarding this one. So he soon became used to dash without breakfast. He soon became used to dash without. So the expression what is became used to or become used to. So if we have a noun after become used to, no problem. We require it. If we have a pronoun, no problem. But if we have a verb-like element after become used to, that verb-like element supposed to carry ing. Very, very essential. So here we have. He soon became used to be going. No, we don't need be in this context, please. So B, we have, he soon became used to have gone. No, Arabic case. C, he soon became used to go. No. And D, he soon became used to what? Going. Correct. So he soon became used to going without breakfast. So when you follow principles, you arrive at answers relatively easy manner that. So of course, D is her answer. Then I dash visit the museum, but I have no time now. You see? So in fact, this is about past habitual activity. And I told you the expression is what is used to. U-S-E-D, used to. Something we are doing habitually in the past, but in fact, I'm not doing now. Okay? So A, I used to is wrong because what? The use is not in past tense. And when the expression is supposed to take D to indicate past usual activity, then B we have I'm used to is wrong. Okay, because if we use I'm used to is something you are accustomed to, as we speak. Okay, so of course B is wrong. And it's wrong because even for a number of reasons, the context in which we use I'm used to is wrong. And in fact, because of what? Because this use, okay, I haven't got D after it. And C, we have used to. So C is our answer. I used to visit the museum, but I have no time now. It's correct. C is our answer. And D, we have I'm used to. Oh, well, of course, you have seen now. So like B and of course D, in fact, have one problem in common because they are talking about something you are accustomed to now. So of course, C is wrong. C is our answer. D and B are something synonymous in context that in fact prove very wrong. So the best option has been option C. Option C is our answer. Now let's proceed to something very again special that in fact it is not common in English but is very essential to have in mind. We call it the subjunctive mood. Italian language and in fact and French, they make use of subjunctive very, very actively. The French language, in fact, is a key component of the French language. The subjunctive mood is a very key component of the French language. But in English, it is used and not very commonly used, but it is used in a formal context, discourse. Okay. Now, what is mood in the first place? Mood. M-O-O-D, mood. In grammar, mood is the form a verb takes to indicate the attitude of the one using the verb. Mood is the form a verb takes to indicate the attitude of the one using the verb. That's it. So we have a number of moods, but we have three prominent among the indicators, which are in fact, I will in fact tell you. So we have what we refer to as the indicative mood. The indicative mood is one that has to do with giving you ordinary, statement, or in fact, relating fact, or even asking question at that. So I would say, for instance, are you there? That one is indicative mood, okay? Or God exists forever. It's fact. Are we there? So when you express opinion, I think Abu is correct. I think it's opinion. So the statement is opinionated. So when you ask question, when you express it, when you express fact, and of course, and when you, you know, when you express sentiment, or shall I say express opinion, this we call, I mean, the verbs there are in fact in the indicative mood. Okay? Then we have another kind we call imperative mood. When you command, go home, sit down, stand here, write the news, for instance. This we call, of course, the imperative mood. Then we have the subjunctive mood. I mean, subjunctive mood has to, of course, has to do with, you know, expressing idea contrary to fact, expressing wish, you know, these are, we call them subjunctive mood. We have some verbs and expressions that, in fact, will attract this mood, subjunctive mood. Now, when we use the present form of subjunctive mood, meaning the elements that will attract subjunctive, these words will fall, in a sentence that contains two clauses, an independent clause and a dependent clause or subordinate clause. So an independent clause is one that can stand on its own. A dependent or subordinate clause is one that cannot stand on its own. So I will not even go further talking about these ones because we have not come to them yet. But I'm just saying, let me just put this one for you. Let me just give you another way that you can see them. Okay, another way that you can see them. So let me say, look at these words. We have demand, we have insist, we have recommend, we have advice, we have request, we have suggest, we have refer, and we have the expression, it is important or it is important if you are in America, it is necessary in America, or it is necessary if you want to sound happy, and of course, it is essential or it is essential at that. So these are expressions and words. If you have these expressions and words in a sentence, when we use them, we require two parts to the sentence. The first part will contain this word. The other part will begin with that. Okay? After the that, you will have a subject. After the subject, the verb coming after the subject supposed to be in base form. Meaning, the verb coming after the subject should not carry any S, should not carry any two after it, should not be in past tense, okay, should be in a pro-like form, no S, no ing, no anything. Please, again, when we use demand, insist, recommend, advise, request, suggest, refer, it is important, it is necessary, or it is essential. When we use them in a sentence, with two parts, they are in fact supposed to come, in the first part. Then, we, of course, have to see in the second part. The second part, we should begin with that. After that, we require a subject. After a subject, we require a verb that is in base form, a verb with no S, a verb with no ing, a verb not in past tense, a verb that is plural based. Very, very essential. So again, let me go again, please. When we use these words, demand, insist, recommend, advise, request, suggest, refer, and the expression, it is important, necessary, and it is essential, we are to use them in a sentence that has got two parts. They are to appear in the first part. The other part should start with that. And after that, we require a subject. And after a subject, we require a verb that should be in base form. We require a verb that lacks ing, a verb that lacks s, a verb, in fact, having no true after it. Okay, a verb that is plural based. Okay, a verb that is plural based. Let it be in your mind, please. So, if we are to talk about subjunctive mood, let's put our explanation into context by giving you some examples. Now, see here. The president or the president. President. P-R-E-S-I-D-N-T. So the S there is Z. Prezi. It's president, not president. So the president demands that Mr. Kuruma sign the papers now. Now imagine the first clause contains the word demand. Okay, that's the first aspect I told you. So we say when we use demand, insist, recommend, it is important. We require, I mean, we require them to appear in a sentence having two parts. They are to form part of the first part, and the other part supposed to begin with that. After that, we need subject. After subject, we require, I mean, a verb that what? That is in base form. A verb not having S, not ing, not to. Okay? So here, demand has in fact fallen in the first aspect of the sentence, demand. The other aspect begins with what? Begins with that. That Mr. Kuruma, of course, signed the paper. And here we have what? We have the subject. And after the subject, we have a verb. This verb is supposed to be in best form. No S, no ing, no to, okay? In if we had not got, if we had not got demands in the first aspect of our clause, then of course, we would have what? We would have had the need to add S to sign. Zakaruma signs the papers now. Okay, so that's the reality. So we'll add S to it to what? To conform to agreement. But when they appear like this, we are not to add any S to the verb. The verb supposed to appear in subjunctive mood. Okay, in this context, please. So two parts to it. The other one is, I suggest that Usman come back at once. So the first aspect of the sentence has been, I suggest, is an independent clause. We have the other aspect, that Usman come back. And here we have the that aspect, we have Usman being the subject, and we have the verb, of course, come. See, we don't have any S after come, no ing, no anything. So the verb come is in the subjunctive mood. Next, we have the expression, it is important. This is what? It's an independent clause. It's the first aspect of the sentence. We have the that aspect, and in this other aspect, we have Karim is the subject, and we have get. You see, we have no S after get. You see, it is important that Karim get a bank loan. You cannot say it's important that Karim gets a bank loan to fulfill the idea about agreement, subject of agreement. No, that one plays no role here at all. Okay, it plays no role here at all. So it is important that you be here on time. So it is important, it is the first component of the sentence, okay, that you be here on time in that aspect, and B is, of course, in subjunctive mood. So there are no past questions for this one, but they are very essential to learn because there are times you find the need to use them, and using them correctly is very essential. You see, remember, English is a language. So it's a language, and if we want to speak with some amount of poshness, with some amount of, and I mean, some amount of value in our speech, or shall I say writing, we require all these ones. We need to understand all of these ones. English does not make extensive use of this mood. French, of course, does so. Italian, the Italian language also does so. Okay? So, of course, that's, of course, we form the last part of the first part of our class. We will go for a break, or we'll come back, we will look at some pronunciation. And then we'll have some good things for you when we come back.
Since the inception of the West African Senior Secondary School Certificate Examination, university requirement has largely called for 5 subjects. Mandatory among these are English language and mathematics. Every year, thousands of students run into the course of either having to resit for not getting credits on English and mathematics, or painfully changing career path or into same. To help modify this narrative, Star Television presents on your screen Learning Garage, a platform that guarantees better performance in English language and mathematics with a team of experienced teachers. To this solution, you all are invited, especially those facing WASC. Learning Garage comes to you on Mondays, Wednesdays, and Fridays from 7 p.m. to 8 p.m. UP's broadcasts are screened on Saturdays from 7 a.m. to 8 a.m. and on Sundays from 1 p.m. to 2 p.m. Join host Ali Santa Kamara.
If you mean such element, then of course we say the waters of the world in that regard.
And Babatunde Gaira Lamin on these days to make a world of difference.
Action that has a numerator which is less than the denominator, we term it as a proper fraction.